long does it take you to recognize a song? There used to be a famous TV show called Name That Tune, where people would hear parts of a song, or usually the first part of a song, and they had to guess what the song was. So here's a little song, and let's see if we can guess what song this is, and how many notes does it take to recognize this particular song. Well, this song right here is Mary Had a Little Lamb, and it takes about all seven of those notes to recognize Mary Had a Little Lamb. But if we were to take the same thinking into surface texture, how long do we need to measure to know what this surface really looks like? Here's a little bit of data that might lead us to believe this surface looks kind of random, but had we kept going, we may encounter some valleys in the surface and find out it's not necessarily a random surface, but it's a plateaued surface with deep valleys occurring every once in a while. So the length of data we measure, or the length of data we analyze in surface texture, is kind of like the song. We need enough of it to understand the music or the story of the surface. If we consider a long surface, let's make a very long component here. Maybe it's a shaft, maybe it's a face of a part, and we now need to measure this for roughness. It may not make sense to measure the entire length. So what we have is a recommendation in standards regarding the evaluation length. It's called LN for evaluation length, and the evaluation length is typically 5 times the filter cutoff wavelength, lambda C. So this wavelength separates roughness from waviness, and we're going to typically measure 5 times that wavelength so we can construct a waviness line running through the surface and do a roughness analysis on that. Typically, this evaluation length is 4 millimeters, and that's for cases where lambda C, the cutoff wavelength, is 0.8 millimeters, which is quite common. So this is a typical analysis of a big surface. The surface is quite long. We're going to measure and analyze some area in the middle. Now, something that happens in this process is we typically need to measure more than the evaluation length. This area right here that I've X'd out and this area that I've X'd out here are needed not for the instrument to speed up and slow down, but they're more needed for the filtering process. Our filter is a moving average, so that moving average needs data on both sides to actually calculate this ending average point. So we're going to evaluate 4 millimeters, but we may have to measure more, like 4.8 millimeters or 5.6 millimeters in order to get that. So this is a typical scenario of a long surface where we're going to measure a piece of it to kind of get an idea for the roughness of that surface. Now perhaps this is going to run up against some other surface, and maybe for waviness we'll need a longer length, but for roughness, the default, according to standards, is 5 times the cutoff wavelength. Here's a problem though. Sometimes we're going to encounter a situation, maybe even in the same surface, where there's a small area of surface. Maybe this area is so small that we cannot fit the entire 4 millimeter length in this space. This 4 millimeter length is too long for the amount of available surface. This happens in things like O-ring grooves, perhaps the bottom of this feature, or in small rings or washers or other sealing surfaces. Now, what some people often will do is they'll say, I need 5 times the filter cutoff, so they change the filter cutoff. That's the wrong approach. If I take this filter cutoff and make it smaller so I can fit 5 of them in this area, I may be in a situation where waviness completely follows the surface and I get no roughness. Instead of seeing these nice trends for waviness with a 0.8 millimeter cutoff, my waviness with a short filter may follow the shape of the surface entirely and we would see no roughness. It would all be waviness. This is a problem. This is not what we want to do. So in cases of a short surface like this, what we really should do is another approach. We don't need to have 5. It's a recommendation, not a requirement. So perhaps we can use fewer cutoffs or fewer sampling lengths. Another option would be to switch to perhaps spline filtering instead of Gaussian. But an ultimate approach that may work best for you if it's a very, very short surface is simply switch your world. Instead of looking at RA, let's use the parameter PA and simply level the surface with a line. Since it's very short, that will act like a filter. And then we will retain all of the shape of the cusps in this case in a parameter very similar to RA. So the bottom line is, if you have a short surface, don't treat it as if it needs to be analyzed differently. In this case, the short surface is going to be in the same contact as the long surface. We need to be smart about our filtering based on function, not based on the length of the surface. If you have questions about short surfaces, long surfaces, or filtering, we are happy to help. Reach out to us at digitalmetrology.com.